Hi, Chris Chinnock here for Insight Media. It's CES 2025. This is the Tianma suite. They're showing a number of automotive products, so let's take you through them. First up, they show me here is this 3D heads up display. It's basically an LCD panel with a parallax barrier on top that includes some eye tracking. The eye tracking is used to set the intrapupillary distance to set the left and right eye images. And there's a button there that you can actually change. I'm not sure if this image is going to be visible through the camera here, but you can also, there's a button here that you can move an icon forward and back. And I guess you could see it moving there in the image. It is 3D, but it's a very narrow eye box. If I move my head just a little bit, everything's got a lot of severe ghosting. So it would be, well, clearly they need to make a bigger eye box, one. And as you move out of the eye box, it would be better to have the image just go to black rather than to go to ghosting. But that's a design consideration. 8-inch HUD, which is based on a microLED panel. It is nice and bright and could be used in a standard HUD application like this or in the panoramic display application we saw before. Let's move on to the cockpit demonstrator over here. So first is this black band panoramic display. Some people call this a HUD. It's not really a HUD. It's just 3 12.3-inch modules that are reflecting off this black band. We've seen this a number of companies here at CES. In front of me here is a 3D display. I am not sure about. Let's see. It says it's eye tracked and it's 2D to 3D switchable. 30-degree field of view. It's okay. It's better than the HUD. It's got a bigger eye box, but there is some blurriness. There's like a little a motion demo. It's going through here, automatic motion demo, and when it pushes the stuff out of the screen, it goes blurry. So you want to keep images in the screen or negative parallax, which they're not doing. So again, more things to think about. We also have these, they call these InvisiView, these wood grain panel displays up there, as well as one down here in the armrest. Here is the InvisiView display again. So this is what they showed at the Display Week last May. And a nice wood grain texture. The issue here is transmissivity. This is only about 50% transmissive, so obviously you have to have a much stronger backlight and therefore power consumption to be able to drive this to decent luminance. The new version has actually increased the transmittance now to 80%, so this is a much more viable and attractive display option here. Another version of this, another kind of integration version to show customers, using the InvisiView and a display on top. And then they have this, they call this a smart module. This looks like something that might actually be in mass production here. And one of the things they highlight on this is this volume button. It's actually has a touch sensor. Turn the volume on and off, and the detente knobs are not connected to any shaft. It's just spinning here, but it's apparently using the touch sensor that's embedded in this panel to actually do the volume control. So it's kind of a different implementation and different use of that technology. This one includes embedded NFC. Sensor. It's right in the bezel down below here, and includes an ambient light sensor as well. So it will detect the ambient light and change the gamma of the display, because certainly with HDR displays, you want to change the gamma based on the ambient light in the environment. This is a 15.6-inch wide refresh rate, so what they're highlighting here is the ability to go from 40 to 120 hertz. It's an LTPS backplane. All these are automotive grade that we're they're going through here. This demo, 14.6 inches, a high transmittance device. Over here is a QD quantum dot with mini LEDs, so a nice bright white color gamut here and good contrast. Finally, over here is these are dual 13-inch OLED displays, and they work with Corning to develop this. This actually has two curved profiles, so the right side is slightly less curved than the driver's side here, the one that's in front of the steering wheel. So it's very special bonding technique developed with Corning on that one. So that is, from an automotive perspective, what they're showing here at CES. There's many other displays, of course, in their suite, but let's just focus on automotive for this report. Chris Chinnock for Insight Media.